Hello, good morning. Welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox One version. This is the retail. It was recently updated with a patch yesterday, which has fixed a lot of the problems, including the D-pad shortcut issue. This is a very quick, short tutorial on how to use a repair projector. Welcome to the Vagabond Star. We are going to damage this ship, and we are going to repair it. I'm going to damage a non-essential component, although I can damage anything. And if you notice, I can instantly weld that back up once I get in the right place. There. So, how's this done? This is a repair projector. Here it is. When you place it, make sure two lines are facing the front. The top is the X. And that is your placement. When you've got that, you just need to make sure you have a blueprint of your ship already. Now, if you don't know how to do that, I have another tutorial on blueprinting if you want to go and watch that. Otherwise, straight into it, into the cockpit seat, hold down both bumpers, press the inventory button, and you're in. So now we want the projector. So we go to projector by typing the first four letters, and we want to make sure that we keep our projection, and we want to make sure we select a blueprint. In this case, it's the Vagabond Star. Then we press A and we wait a bit, and it will warn you that multiple grids are not supported. Only the largest grid will be used. This is if you have ships docked to it. I have a small shuttle docked to the back. So then, press left, trigger, right trigger, go back to the search bar. Again, we want the projector. Now, what it's doing is telling you, because I've already installed this blueprint properly, that it's out of bounds. So what we want to look at is how to get it into place. If it's not in the correct position, and there are several sliders that move it around. If I change the forward offset to the left, you'll see it moves backwards. To the right, it moves forwards. If you want to move these sliders fast, hold down the right bumper, and it'll zip backwards and forwards really quickly. Hold down the left bumper, and it'll zip fairly slowly. If you want to get to either end or the centre fast, hold down both bumpers, press left, we've already got, press right, it'll take you to the middle, press right again, it'll take you to the far right of the slider, back again on left will take you straight to the middle, good for turning speed down to zero on rotors and so on. Okay, so now, if you look, we can bring this projection into place slowly. And what you're looking for is the warning that the projection is out of bounds. Once that is displayed, your projector is correctly projecting the blueprint. All you've got to do is make sure these sliders are in the right place and the orientation matches your actual ship. Once that's done, then this will help you with your damage. Lose any component, including so long refinery, my big refinery, and it will project a ghost. Then you can weld it back up, and everything is back to normal. Although, the warning is if you lose your cockpit, all your controls will become unlinked, and so on. So anything that had links to it will become unlinked. One thing you might want to do is add your projector to your cockpit or another button panel, and that's simple. Go into your cockpit, hold down the direction you want, select the projector in your list of all blocks and just select toggle block on and off. And then you can conserve power by turning your projector on and off. So when you need it, pop in your cockpit, turn it on, blue lights, it's projecting. Repair the thing, pop in your cockpit, turn it off. Simple as that. And that's a very short, to the point tutorial on projectors, how to place them, remember, plus to the top, two lines to the front, and that will project your blueprint so you can maneuver it correctly and put it in place. That's it really. You can use projectors to create blueprints. If I had a big enough welding room and all the parts, I could recreate the Vagabond Star in survival by using a projector. We'll cover that a bit later on in another video. And that's all I really have to say. Thank you very much for watching. Stay safe, take care. Until the next one, goodbye.